This is preseason training tape number 15. It's a short tutorial on the play clock, produced by one of our referees out of Arizona, Reed Brotherton. Appreciate the hard work. He put this together after a consultation with several of our referees in the league. It's an excellent tutorial, and we'll be sure to forward this to all the clock operators in the league so they know what they're doing this season. Hopefully they pay some attention. Here we go.
Hey everybody, this is Reed Brotherton, IFL referee, doing my best impression of Tom. We're going to look at the 40 and 25 second play clock change for the 2024 season. Now the vast majority of us are working NCAA, and there's not really any big difference other than number 6. After any kick, the play clock shall be set to 25 seconds and started on the referee's ready for play signal. So here we have a kickoff that's grounded out of bounds. Nothing changes from last year. We're going to have a 25-second play clock after all kicks. So a scrimmage kick or a free kick, the play clock shall be set to 25 seconds. So as you can see, the 25 second play clock is running down. We have a snap and we have a completion over the middle. Once the runner is tackled, the play clock operator will notice that the calling official is given the dead ball signal and wait a heartbeat and then start the 40 second play clock as shown on the screen. So once again, Tucson gained some yardage. We have the runner tackled. The play clock operator takes a heartbeat and then begins the 40 second play clock. Back judges, it's really important, as you would in an NCAA game, to have a good pregame with the play clock operator to let them know of the rule change and to be consistent with the 40 second play clock at the end of plays for both teams. As we watch the next play, we're going to see a change from last year. Tucson is going to score a touchdown. At the conclusion of the touchdown, once the calling official drops his hands, that's when the 40-second play clock will begin. So right now, the play clock begins. Referees, we want to use some discernment on these types of plays. We do have a score. In this situation, the offense is very close to where the touchdown was scored, so they have plenty of time to get the play off. However, if we have a long walk for either team, it might be in our best interest to display a one-handed pump to reset the play clock to 25 seconds. Back judges, this is something that your play clock operator should be aware of in case it happens. We're going to skip ahead in the game to a scoring play. Here we have a touchdown by Northern Arizona. We also have an unsportsmanlike foul against Northern Arizona. So this would be a situation where we would not have a 40-second play clock due to the administrative stoppage. After the announcement, we would go into a 25-second play clock. So we move to the next kickoff. The ball is kicked deep, out of bounds, beyond the end zone. Now we have a banked foul to enforce. Banked foul enforcement is an administrative stoppage, plus we have a kick, so the play clock shall be set to 25 seconds. The previous play ended with a running clock where the offense chose to take a timeout. After timeouts, the play clock is set to 25 seconds and begins with the referee's ready for play signal. If the defense is awarded a first down, the play clock shall be set to 25 seconds and will start on the referee's ready for play signal. As you can see, we're getting extremely close to the end of the first half. As Tom would say, we need to have laser focus with the game clock and the play clock. Here, there's a penalty for roughing the passer because we have a penalty that is an administrative stoppage. The play clock shall be set to 25 seconds and will begin on the referee's ready for play signal. Another situation where we'll have a 40-second play clock is an incomplete forward pass. The play clock operator will take a heartbeat and then begin the 40-second play clock after seeing the incomplete pass signal. When under 1 minute and a half, if the ball becomes dead due to the runner being contacted into the wall, or if the runner gives himself up by placing the ball over the wall, the play clock operator will take a heartbeat and then begin the 40-second play clock. In summary, it's really important for our play clock operators to be consistent and automatically reset the 40-second play clock at the end of a regular scrimmage play. So there are some triggers to look for with these scrimmage plays. First, if there's a ball that's declared dead in the field of play, you're going to look for that dead ball signal, wait a heartbeat, and then start the 40-second play clock. If there is an incomplete pass, you'll see the incomplete signal, wait a heartbeat, and then start the 40-second play clock. And last but not least, when there's under 1 minute and a half, if the ball becomes dead over the wall out of bounds, and the stop the clock signal is given, wait a heartbeat, and then start the 40-second play clock. Thank you for your attention.
Excellent job, Mr. Brotherton. Much appreciated. And I am Tommy F., and I approve this message.